Laser cutting plastic real fuming. it contains chlorine gas.
Never use lasers to cut plastic.
A YouTuber once analyzed in his video that laser cutting plastic is absolutely harmful and shared a small experiment called the Bellstein test to detect the presence of coloring in plastic. The experiment is really helpful, but I believe that laser cutting plastic, even if it produces harmful gases, is the only choice for certain applications. Many car manufacturers like BMW and Mercedes use laser cutting for plastic bumpers, dashboard, headlight, and other plastic parts. Are they afraid of getting poisoned? Clearly, they are not.
When it comes to cutting car parts like bumpers, precision is crucial. And only laser cutting with a cutting accuracy of 0.03 mm can achieve it. For some plastic products with curved surface or intricate details, only laser can provide automatic pokers to ensure cutting precision. This high level of automation and quality cannot be achieved by other traditional methods like wet jet cutting and punching. Laser cutting plastic becomes the only and the best choice for manufacturing these products.
Considering the cutting quality, choosing other methods is impractical. For example, sawing and milling may damage the surface, causing fracture and producing rough edges. Similarly, common methods like hot knife cutting also generate toxic gases due to high temperature and have extremely low precision when manually operated. However, when it comes to cutting process components like gears, sliders, dashboard panels, and medical device parts, non-contact laser cutting plastic always ensures that the workpiece is not damaged by mechanical stress, resulting in a very smooth cutting surface.
In addition to cutting common plastic sheets and board, laser can also cut extremely thin plastic films. The high cutting speed and powerful laser energy ensure that the films are not melted while being cut. For example, our customer who use laser cutting for goggle lens films achieve perfect quality.
But laser are not a cure-all. Not all plastic products are suitable for laser cutting.
For cutting products like plastic bottles and pipes with no precision requirement, plastic pipe cutter, blade sharpener, and hot wire bottle cutters are commonly used, which are suitable for manufacturers producing simple plastic products in large quantities. In addition, for small workshop or craft makers, DIY plastic decorations, cutting doors and windows, tools like circuit cutters, utility knives, or razors may be simpler and more convenient. Of course, always wear gloves to prevent injury.
So, is laser cutting plastic really safe?
In fact, many plastics such as acrylic, PC, PP, PE, Dairing, and mylar can be safely laser cut without producing toxic gases. Here's a table for your reference. Furthermore, the advent of fume extractor has effectively solved the problem of toxic films. They can absorb and purify any waste gases and smoke generated during laser cutting, ensuring the safety of operators and machines while being highly effective in environmental protection. When combined with features like air blowing system and enclosure designs, you can achieve safe plastic cutting.
Alright, so safety concerns are addressed, but what if the machine gets corroded by chlorine gas or other toxic fumes? Indeed, that's an undeniable possibility. However, let's do some cost analysis. Most laser cutting machines experience different degree of wear and tear after 10 years of use. But meanwhile, laser cutting plastic can generate significant production benefit. You can make big profit. The return on investment far outweighs the initial machine cost. It's cost-effective and worthwhile investment.
Moreover, to meet the cutting needs of different plastic products such as cutting plastic water sprue and curved automotive components, we can customize different work platforms and templates to improve production efficiency.
So, do you still think laser can't cut plastic? Of course, for safety reasons, it's essential to properly set the laser cutting power, speed, air blowing, exhaust fans, and fume extractors. For a detailed guide on how to set up and adjust these parameters, please leave your question in the comments. We or other experienced viewers can provide you with timely assistance. And if you are still concerned, wearing a mask or goggle is the better choice for you. Alright, that's wrap up today's video. We hope to have answered all your questions and provide valuable insight. If you found this video helpful for yourself or for your friends, don't hesitate to hit the like and the share button below. We will continue to bring you more valuable contents, so make sure to subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. See you in the next video.